Good morning, everybody. This is Rahul from QuickHeal Technologies. Thank you for joining us for this webinar on Gmail security. The webinar will be presented by Mr. Nikhil More. Nikhil is an online marketing manager at QuickHeal Technologies Private Limited. He has over 9 years' experience in digital marketing and a passion for technology, usability, and photography. Nikhil is also a recognized expert in internet marketing strategies for the antivirus industry. At QuickHeal, Nikhil is associated with the cybersecurity program, which is the company's corporate social responsibility initiative. With that in mind, I'll now hand over the mic to Nikhil so that you can begin the webinar with him.
Good morning, everyone, and a warm welcome to today's webinar on Gmail security. This is a very generic topic that we would be taking, but it's a very important topic. And we have realized through all the communication we have with our customers, the primary email that a lot of our customers use is Gmail. And having this email security is a concern for a lot of people, because there are so many security parameters introduced by Gmail, but they go uninformed because people are not educated about it. So this is our initiative, where we would be educating our customers about the important aspects of Gmail security. If you please feel free to make notes during this webinar, but don't worry, we will be sharing you a recording of this webinar. We will be hosting it on our YouTube channel. We will also be sharing with you the presentation for today's webinar, which would be hosted on our SlideShare account. Now, without any further delay, I will now begin the webinar. Let's quickly discuss the topics that we'll be covering today. Gmail, a brief introduction about what Gmail is all about. Why is Gmail security important? Security features which are provided by Google in its email client as Gmail. What are the important steps you need to take to secure your Gmail account, interesting facts and cases, and lastly, but the most important, how can QuickHeal help you? I think there is some technical problem with this webinar. Okay, so let me just go back to the topics again. The topics that we'll be covering would be Gmail, brief information about what Gmail is all about, why is the Gmail security so important, security features provided by Google in its email client, that's Google's Gmail, securing your Gmail account, interesting facts and cases, and how can QuickHeal help in securing your email client. Let's go forward to discuss what is brief information about Gmail. Now, Gmail started in the year 2004 on the 1st of April. That's approximately 11 years ago, close to 11 years ago. Initially, interestingly, Gmail was just by invite. So people who already have Gmail accounts would be able to invite others to Gmail account. Now, people use Gmail's webmail as well as the POP3 or IMAP4 protocols to use Gmail. The full version of Gmail was released to the general public in the year 2007, the month of February. And although that was a beta status for the Gmail client, the service was upgraded to a full version of Gmail in 2009 in the month of July. There are close to 425 million active users on Gmail, and Gmail gives you a 15 GB of free storage to store information on Google Drive, your Gmail, or your Google Plus photos. Your storage is based on which applications you use directly, The Picasa is now known as the Google Plus Photos, which is associated with your Google Plus account. Moving forward, this time let's go with an interesting opinion poll. I would like to know from you more, since this is a webinar about Gmail security. So let's start with an interesting poll. A strong password has only numbers and letters associated with it. Is it true? Is it false? It's a time to cast your vote and tell us, what do you think about a strong password? When I say a strong password, I am referring to a password which is not easy to guess by any of the third parties except for you. So strong password only has numbers and letters. What do you people think? We have approximately 50% of today's audience cast their vote. I will give you another 10 more seconds to finish your votes, and after that I will show you the results for today's opinion poll. Again, I'm talking about a strong password which you use for any of your email accounts, maybe your social networking accounts or your internet banking accounts. This is a combination of letters and numbers. We have close to about 75% of today's audience casted their vote. I will now close this poll and share with you the results. So 65% of today's audience feels that no, it is more than that. Your strong password has a combination of not only numbers and letters but also other factors. Now what are the other factors? The other factors could be special characters, could be letters into capital and small. So let's move forward. Why is Gmail security so important? Your Gmail message lasts forever. So once you receive an email, it is there in your account till the time you delete it. Now, what are these messages? These messages are related to your banking information. These are related to your account numbers, various account numbers that you might have, especially for salaried people who are working professionals. Your salary slips are into your Gmail account. Your personally identifiable information about your near and dear ones, about your important dates like birthdays and anniversaries, important dates like your insurance renewal for your home insurance, your car insurance, any of that sort. Personal photographs of your near and dear ones, your friends, families. Private messages, information that you would not like to share with anybody else, information that you would like to keep it to yourself. Those are also stored on your Gmail. Professional information about your track record of your medical history, track record of your employment history, track record of any of your association with various groups that you might have. This is all professional information that is included in your Gmail, and it's all stored there. So it's important for you to make sure that your Gmail account stays protected. Why am I saying this? Google came up with this policy of one password for all your Google accounts. Now, you must be wondering that you might probably know Gmail, YouTube, Picasa, Google Plus. But let me tell you, there are more than 200 plus products as well as services that Google provides. This information is being displayed on Wikipedia. It's nice to know that you can use so many services with one username and one password. But it's also dangerous, because if you lose that username and password, you are compromising the security of all those applications you use. Those applications contains your email, it contains your calendars, contacts, your documents, photos, videos, music. What have you searched? Your search history, your bookmarks, your financial information, your location information, location history of places you have visited, your Google Plus posts, blogs, and all the apps of Google that you have installed. All of this is readily available with this one login. Very important that you keep it secured all the time. Moving forward, what are the security features provided by Gmail? There's an attachment scanner that comes with every Gmail account. So Gmail automatically scans all your attachments for viruses. What happens when a virus is found? If a virus is detected on any of your attachments that you send to your email, the message is rejected and it's notified to the sender. As a precautionary measure, you won't be able to download any of the messages or files which consist a virus or a malware recognized by Google. If an attachment you are trying to send is infected with the virus, Gmail will display an error message to tell you, but it won't clean the file. You can see the error message that you will see as a warning message on your site. Moving forward, spam filtering. You know, this is a very common problem that a lot of people face. What are the different spam filters that Gmail uses to stop people? So you have three types of filters. You have text filters, you have blacklist, and you have client filters. Now, text filters work by using algorithms that Google uses to detect words and phrases which are most commonly used into spam emails. Now, these phrases could be Vicodin, online pharmacy, mail enhancement. These are oftenly flagged and removed by these filters. Spammers have got wise when they saw that Gmail using the security measure to block those emails, and they started using blatant spelling mistakes and using and substituting characters with symbols. See, for example, the word sale could be written as SA, a hashtag or an exclamation mark and E. So that way it would display it as sale. But fortunately, modern spam filters also make allowances of these types of spellings, and if a word comes up, even the character substitutions, and with these character substitutions, the messages will be blocked. Client filters. In addition to simple text algorithms, the top spam filter uses client identity and history to block malicious or annoying spam emails. How does the spam filter work? This is done by looking at the email messages a certain user has sent out to others. If they send out huge amount of emails constantly, or if several of their messages are already been marked as spam through text filters, these emails are often blocked entirely. Blacklist. Google maintains a list of blacklisted email IDs, and their messages invariably end up in spam folder of the receivers. Now, the spam filters also include blacklist. Blacklisting is simply the process of adding the known email addresses of a spammer to a list of blacklist. This list prevents any inbound messages from the email address going forward. If you mark something as spam, it will go into the blacklist. And it may also help Google make a note of certain keywords in that spam email. Client filters. The spam filters use client identity and history to block malicious emails that they send. HTTPS. What does HTTPS stand for? It stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. Gmail always uses encrypted HTTPS connection. Now, what does this HTTPS do? HTTPS makes it more difficult for a hacker or anyone who's trying to spy your network to read the message. Now, HTTPS in detail would make sure that the messages which are being transmitted to from the sender to the receiver goes into a format which is not a plain text format, because a plain text format is easily to eavesdrop upon and spy your conversation. So Gmail makes sure that your conversation or your email that you sent out is encrypted using HTTPS connection. Time for another poll. I would like to know from you, if you have, if you use social media from your accounts, your official accounts, do you need to have separate email IDs for it? My question is, should you or should you not have separate email addresses for your social and official accounts? If you'd like me to repeat the question, should you or should you not have separate email addresses for your social or official account? Is it true to have separate accounts? Is it false? We have about 50%, 52% of today's audience already casted their vote. I would give you another 10 seconds to finish your votes, after which I will close this poll and share with you the results. We have about 73% of today's audience casted their vote. I think I will wait for another 5 seconds before I close the opinion poll. Okay, so let's see what today's audience feels about this opinion poll. 75% of all the audience who have casted their vote today feel that it's true. You should have separate email accounts for your social accounts, for your personal as well as official accounts. So it's very important that you do not compromise security, because if you have the same ID both for your official accounts and same email address for your social accounts, then your email security gets compromised. So pat your backs, audience. It's a very correct decision of yours to make sure that you have separate email accounts for your official account. So let's move forward. Securing your Gmail account, it's a step-by-step guide. If you have your Gmail account and if you want to take notes, this is the time now. First step is log into your Gmail account. You log into your Google account. You see a login screen. After that, you go to your account. So this is how your account page looks like. So you have a button where we have marked it. You click on this account link. After that, you would see a security checkup. So there is something called as get started on the security check. Once you click on this get started button, you would see information where you can add recovery information. Now, what is this recovery information? Let me explain it to you. Recovery options, these help secure your account from account hijackers, and it also gives you the access to your account in case you forget your password. If you already have implemented these security steps, then mind you, please visit these settings for your backup email and your backup phone number on a very frequent basis, so that you can keep a check on making sure that the account is updated with your latest phone number and the current email address that you use. Now, why use a mobile phone as a backup option? A mobile phone is one of the easiest and the fastest way to help protect your account. It's more secure than your recovery email address because you actually have your phone with you all the time. Giving a recovery phone number to Google won't result you in being signed up for marketing list or getting more calls from telecallers. Email, your recovery email address can be used to send an email to reset your password if you get locked out or you can challenge an account hijacker. Let's move forward. Now when you're done with it, click on the done button and move to check your recent activity sessions. So what are recent activity sessions? Last account activity shows you information about the recent activity in your mail. Recent activity includes any time your mail was accessed using your regular web browser, a pop-up client, a mobile device, a third-party application, etc. The IP address is detected every time when you access your email, and the location and time and date as well is seen. So if you are looking at the screen at the moment, you would see that you have signed in 27 times from a Windows operating system using a Firefox browser at 5 p.m. today from a location in Maharashtra. So this is all information that you can keep a track of and know and make sure that nobody else is using your account in your absence or on your behalf. Let's move forward. If everything looks good, move to the next checkpoint called as check your account permissions. On the account permissions, you can see a list of third-party websites and applications. These sites and applications which you have granted permission to access your Google account, and you can see a list of what part of the account they have an access to. For example, you might have downloaded an app that helps you schedule workouts with your friends. This application might have requested access to your Google Calendar and contacts and suggest times and friends for you to meet up with. Once you're done with the security checkup, now it's time to click on account settings. Once you click on account settings, this is the most important thing that you will see. It's called as a two-step verification. Most people only protect their accounts with passwords. However, a two-step verification will protect your account with your password and your phone. If a bad guy manages to steal or guess your password, he'll also need to have your phone with him to access your account. Signing with a two-step verification works a little differently. You will enter your password as usual, and then you will provide a verification code that you will get on your phone. You can make this process simpler for computers and devices that you use often. Other step to boost your Gmail security: set a strong password, a combination of uppercase, lowercase letters, numbers, symbols. Please avoid date of births, names, your personal name, your spouse name, or your favorite actor, or any other personally identifiable information, because these are easily tracked by bad guys and your account security gets compromised. Set unique passwords for every account. So for example, if you are using your net banking with your social media accounts, with your Gmail accounts, with any other accounts, make sure you have a strong password, a different password for every of these accounts, because that would not only help you increase the security of your account, but it will also safeguard you when a bad guy attempts to hack into your data to steal the information. Avoid setting up autoresponders. What are autoresponders? These responders are basically messages that are sent out to your senders automatically without your intervention. These messages become a source of spam, because when you send out an autoresponder, they actually get your actual email address and they can send you spam messages, which is not good for any account holder to receive. Very important aspect is you should always avoid setting a vacation autoresponder with location information, because this will reveal the time and date and the location till which you are not in your account. This could be an invitation to a burglar to break into your house and do the bad thing. Most importantly, always sign out your account when you are done working on it. It's easy to close the browser, but it's not advisable for that you should close the browser. You should sign out from the account clear the cache or the cookies from the browser and then close the browser. It's always the best practice to do that. Time for another opinion poll from you people. If what should you do when you receive an unknown email that asks you to download an attachment? I'm sure a lot of people have gone through this situation where you receive an email from an unknown source, person that you don't know from, and it might have an invitation for you to download stuff from the internet. What should you do in this case? Should you download the attachment? You know, they could be good guys sending you good stuff. So you should download the attachment, or you should delete the email. What does today's audience think about it? We have about 45% of today's audience casted their vote. I would give you another 10 seconds before you cast your vote, and I share with you what is the opinion of today's audience about, you know, treating an email from unknown sources which asks you to download an attachment. Wait for another 10 seconds before I close this poll and share the opinion results with you. Okay, I will share the results with you now. Pat your backs, audience. 94% of today's audience feel that they should delete that email on receipt. So it's a very, very important thing to do. Always, people, delete emails when you do not know the source of the email or where it asks you to download an attachment to that email. This could contain viruses. Although as I've told you earlier, that Gmail protects you in case it detects a virus in the attachment of a file, but it's still a best practice to avoid clicking on emails with attachments from unknown sources. Simple rules that we follow in everyday life. We should not trust strangers with information. The same way, we should not trust emails with unknown sources. Moving forward, interesting facts and cases on Gmail. So Google Drive offered a 2 GB of free storage for doing a quick security checkup. This was till the 17th of February this year. This clearly shows that what is the importance in the eyes of Google for a user's account security. Although the time has passed, but Google insisted all its users to make sure that they have an optimum account security done on their Google or Gmail account. Quick analysis of the leaked passwords. This was a report published by Google in September 2014. The top 10, correction here. This information was shared by one of the password manager software called as LastPass, shared in September 2014. The top 10 most used passwords, you can see on your screen, the top 10 most used passwords, you can see on your screen right now. These passwords are very easy to guess passwords. Now if you look at the screen below, it says 42.5% of the passwords are lowercase letters and a combination of with numbers. 39, almost 40% of passwords are lowercase characters only. 15% passwords are numbers only, and only 1% password is a combination of lowercase letters, numbers and symbols. So people, it's very important for you to have a stronger password. Your, as I said earlier, your password should be a combination of letters on in uppercase, letters in lowercase, numbers, special characters. This will make your password stronger. A quick poll. This would be the last poll for today. If you receive an email from your bank informing that about something urgent and it asks you to click on a link, what should you do? Let me repeat this question. If you receive an email from your bank and it asks you to do something urgent. Now, typically, this is kind of a situation where a bank would say that we have seen an activity on your account which does not seem to be correct for us. Why don't you check this activity and let us know what is happening? What do you think should be done? Should you click on the link that's provided in it, or should you visit your bank's website by typing the name of it in the search engine like Google? What should you do? I have about 65% of today's audience casted their vote. I would now close this opinion poll and share the results with you. 92% of today's audience thinks that it is a good practice to visit a bank's official website using search engine. So exactly, people, this is what you should be doing. Never trust emails because, mind you, banks do not send such kind of emails to its customers saying that you have seen a fraudulent activity in your account, so check it. And it would never do that. So the best thing to do is, even if you think you want to check, go to a search engine like google.com, type in your bank's website address there, and you can log into your account and then check. Let's move forward. How can Quick Heal help you with email security? Quick Heal products gives you a cloud-based email security that blocks spam emails, phishing, and infected emails from reaching your inbox. Now, the anti-spam feature in the Quick Heal products, it blocks these kind of emails, and at Quick Heal use, in our products, we use a live cloud-based protection to check suspicious files, and it restricts, if there is a malware in that file, it restricts that malware to reach your inbox. There are three more aspects that we use in email security. One is the browser sandbox. Browser sandbox is a feature where it protects your browser from clicking on infected emails, clicking on links to infected websites. Email security, as I said earlier, this email would protect your email client from receiving phishing or spam based emails. Web security is again a feature where it would protect your if there is a phishing link in the email that you've received, it will protect you from blocking the access to such links and also help you being infected with such infected or malicious codes. This brings us to the end of this webinar. Thank you very much for joining us on today's webinar. You can visit us on our Facebook page. Our Facebook address is facebook.com/quickheal.av. You can follow us on our Twitter handle, which is twitter.com/quickheal. As I said earlier, the recording of today's webinar will be hosted on our YouTube channel. You can visit us at youtube.com/quickheal, and the presentation for today's webinar will be hosted on SlideShare. So you can make a note of these addresses. In case you have any questions, please feel free to reach us at corporatecommunications@quickheal.co.in. To know more details about Quick Heal products, please visit quickheal.com. And to know more about interesting facts that we publish to our clients, please visit blogs.quickheal.com. I would now hand over the mic to Rahul to conclude this webinar.
Thank you, Nikhil, for those wonderful tips on Gmail security. We hope our audience has gained some deep understanding into how to secure your Gmail accounts. And thank you so much for joining us for this webinar. And please have a good day ahead. Thank you so much.